Hello guys, welcome back to Ushi Gaming Channel. So, another The Alchemist Code Global video. A disclaimer. This account is not my account. It is Gumi's account. Gumi Chu. And here, I have level 85 Gormalas, Deneb, and Soleil. And I want to showcase them in this video. Yeah, too bad that somehow Deneb in this account is only level 1. Okay. Okay, anyway. Last time, I already showcased Meifang using my Japan account. Her attack was 1000 something, which is insanely high because of she just got master ability like last month in Japan, and she doesn't have that master ability yet in global right now. Okay, but as you can see here, her attack is already reached 753 because of the weapon. It is 5 stars, P attack 50, and yeah, the weapon is very good. It has agility 8, critical 15, paralysis 15. And for the ability, Overdrive, this is the one that makes her attack is very high. Without Overdrive, it is only 520. So Overdrive is really good for her. And if you want more damage, I think it's good to use Slash and Strike Mastery. Pierce and Shot, well, it is also good, but that's not her best damage. So basically, this one is Strike. This one is Slash, yep, and this one Shot, missile attack, this one Pierce. Okay, so she has 4 different kind of attack types, and from the basic martial arts, she has some other attacks and also buff, which is nice. Okay, for the reaction ability, Roundhouse Block is very good. Basically, this is like chance to guard, like the one on the Holy Cavalier. Without the gear, her attack is 672, already very high, and the HP is 650, the agility 114, which is actually quite decent if it's in global right now. With the weapon, the agility is 122, that's already very decent. Her leader skill is HP 50% for thunder units, so her damage showcased in this video is kinda like the pure damage without any leader skill, and her damage can be a lot higher with P attack 50% leader skill, like Monzane's leader skill. So her starting MP is 39 at level 85. Okay, the normal attack 1500 to water enemy, 1218 to fire enemy. Okay, somehow the first skill is weaker compared to the normal attack. Okay, so here it is, the skill. The first skill was Daze effect, which is actually very good. And for the second skill, Ogre Slaying Lance, inflict physical damage and sleep and strong versus monsters and penetrating. The damage is somehow lower than the normal attack. The third skill, Burial Gun, physical damage 5 range, height unlimited, stop and strong versus human. The damage is slightly higher than the normal attack. The stop effect is very dangerous, and this is the first skill that she is going to use in arena. And the last skill, Great Death Maw, physical damage on enemy units within area around self and lower speed attack M attack, area 5/5 diamond. Whoa, okay. Whoa. Okay, the damage is very high. And then, the one from the basic ability, Cedar Slash Flicker, inflict physical damage on enemy units within target area and inflict bind and penetrating. Okay, range 3, 1 square line like this. Okay. The damage is higher than the normal attack. Actually, the most dangerous part of Meifang is the status ailments. Almost every of her attacks have status ailments or debuff. The second skill from the basic ability, Nature Slash Trance, inflict physical damage on enemy units within target area around self, area square 3 around self, high 3. Okay, no debuff, no status ailments, just AoE. Okay, but I think she's going to use the one from the main ability, because that one has higher damage than this one, if it's in auto battle. Okay, from the basic. Let's see the damage boost from the buff. Let's try the one from slash attack and strike attack. I think both have the same damage multiplier, but let's see one of them. This way, if I use the slash attack buff, we can compare the damage boost using normal attack. Okay, it is around 10 to 15% damage boost if I use the buff just now, which is nice. Okay, now the master ability from the weapon. Purging Dragon Roar, range 4-5-5 diamonds. This one is very strong, the damage as you can see here. Yeah, it has to be straight line by the way. So, okay, let's use it from here. Like this. Okay. Very good weapon ability. It gives her range 4-5-5 diamonds attack. So, I think the AI will use the, you know, the range 5 stop attack, and then she will use one normal attack. After that, maybe she can use the weapon ability. Okay, so back to the status. She is actually a lot better to use as Martial Master rather than using her as Dark Cavalier. Actually, if you use her as a Dark Cavalier, she has nice agility, which is 120. Yeah, but the P attack is a little bit lower than if you use her as Martial Master, as you can see here. And you know, the P def is also lower as Dark Cavalier. If you use her as Martial Master, you will be able to do a lot of range attacks like this. Dark Cavalier, basically skill wise, it's kinda not as good as Martial Master because of Martial Master also have a lot of status ailments. And yeah, with this kind of P attack, I think, you know, she is able to do very high damage even to win units. Especially if you give her a leader skill that boosts the damage. Maybe Monzane, yeah, something that boosts Thunder units damage. Okay, so that's Meifang. I think she is very good, she is very dangerous in arena and also very good to use for PvE versus monsters. So now Gormalas, I think you guys already know what a pirate holy brawler can do. Basically, he is like the slightly better version of Cheetah, because of Cheetah is martial artist, right? This one is holy brawler. What I mean with better is this: sharpening focus, triple own speed attack. Meanwhile, Cheetah with the martial artist only 2.5 times higher. However, sharpening focus, you can only use this 3 times. From the martial artist charge up, you can use charge up like 5 times. So plus and minus. Okay, and later in the future, Gormalas will get pirate plus job, so he is very dangerous. And the other good thing about Gormalas is the second job, Dragon Knight. It gives HP drain. This is very good. So basically, he will only take around half damage from normal attack. Yeah, because he will absorb back the HP from the enemy based on the damage taken. Very good. And then this. Spirit of the Sea God raises fire resistance and water resistance. And from the weapon, if you have this weapon, he will get thunder resistance. So a pirate that has thunder, fire, water resistance, almost like Divine Shelter, like you know, the half version of Divine Shelter. Yeah, so he is very tough, especially against fire, water, and thunder units. And from the second ability, you can use Iron Body to boost his max HP. That's why his max HP is 1012, even without any Alchemono. If it's with Alchemono, 1264, insanely high. The other abilities, I don't think these abilities will be able to support him as a pirate. So I think the best is using this and yeah, Iron Body and Spirit of the Sea God. If you use him as a holy brawler, of course, Iron Body Strike Mastery. Or this, you can use this. If you want to make him tougher, Iron Body and Spirit of the Sea God, but his damage will be not that good, so Strike Mastery is needed. As a pirate, the status, as you can see here, the agility 106 if it's with Alchemono. If it's with Dorama, 116, which is quite decent. P attack 470, quite standard, I think. Yeah, not bad, of course. It's pretty good, but yeah, quite standard. P def 292, M def 129. Okay. So the good thing about pirate is, if you are new to the pirate job, is anchor cast and milestorm. And the best part is you can use basic fist, sharpening focus, and then use milestorm or anchor cast. Milestorm is the most damaging skill from pirate, the AoE 5 of diamond, by the way. So if you want to use him, you can use him either as pirate or holy blower, up to you. Holy blower is also good. This is his stats as a holy blower. Without drama, battlefield drama, the agility is 130. With battlefield drama, the agility is 134. Not the highest agility for a holy brawler, but okay, still very good. The P attack is 461, quite standard for a holy brawler. Yeah. So the most dangerous part about F-ing Gormalas is, you know, the leader skill P attack 50% for dark units. So you can use him as dark units leader in arena, and then maybe you can use other units like Albea, Kudanstein, or the other dark units. So this is Gormalas. Okay, at least let's try to see the initial jewel at level 85. 38 initial jewel. Wow. He can use Milestorm from the beginning without Snowman Head or the other stuffs. The normal attack damage is 963.64, okay. Milestorm, 1259 to water enemy. It is water elemental attack, by the way, so it will do more damage to fire, lesser damage to thunder. Anchor cast, 1209. Milestorm is better. Raises speed attack and attack. Skull Slash for death sentence. It has lower damage than normal attack, by the way. Okay, now let's try to use sharpening focus, and then let's try to do Milestorm after this. Okay, here we go. Milestorm. The damage is 3718. Oh yeah. The master ability, one range. 3400. So Milestorm is still better. Yep. Okay. So this is his best damage after sharpening focus, 3718. Okay, so that is Gormalas. He is good for both PvE and also PvP. Pirate is a good job. Yeah, especially because of Milestorm and Anchor Cast. And since he is a dark unit, basically, if you want to counter him, you have to use light units, which also means both light and dark units will get extra damage. Yep, so it is going to be hard to counter him with the stronger element. If it's Shita, pirate with wind element, you can use fire units to counter her, but Gormalas is a little bit hard to counter with you know, the stronger element and stuff. Now Soleil, Sage, Bishop, and Enchanter. Okay, so this is her stats with this kind of setup. The magic attack is decent for magic attackers. Yeah, it is kinda standard, 553, because of she has magic up 2 from Sage, Swift Charge to reduce charge time by 1 per 3. And then counter magic. Okay, basically magic counter attack, or you can use magic barrier. Chance of depending when receiving magic damage, and cancel magic, cancel all buff cast on attacker. It is up to you. All of these three are usable, by the way, depend on the quest. So you can use her as a sage with basic holy magic, so that you can use heal, cure, curing rest, giga regen, and subs. So a healer sage, magic attacker that can also heal, very nice. Or you can use the basic enchanter so that you can get boost speed attack or boost magic attack. Or maybe boost agility, boost dex, up to you. If you are using her as a pure sage, I mean pure magic attacker, sorcery and basic enchantment is recommended. Yep. But if you are using her as a semi-support, you can use her basic bishop so that she can heal too. It's nice. On the other side, you can use her as a bishop with sage basic ability like this. The magic attacking should be around the same with the same gear. Only slightly lower as a bishop. What you can get from main bishop is you can use Holy Ray, light magic damage, which you know, sage only have four different kind of elements: fire, water, thunder, wind, right? The main bishop can heal, and you can use Holy Ray and Shining, 100% hit by the way, and then Curing Grace completely recovers HP of ally units and recover status. So very good magic attacker and magic support, half attacker half support. The enchanter, if you need the remove buff, cancel off buff, null wave, you can use enchanter with either basic holy magic or basic sorcery. Basically she is a versatile unit, very versatile magic unit. Yeah, she's actually pretty good. She's a 4 star space unit, right? She will start with full MP, so you can use many skills without worrying about anything. To cover the low HP, you can use Alchemono. She will get 574 max HP, which is still very decent. But I think using Drama should be good because, you know, she needs better agility. If it's on the Sage, it will be 111. Okay, not bad. Okay, so those are the 3 new units. It is too bad that in this account somehow Deneb is only level 1. Maybe they forgot to boost this Deneb, but it's okay. Okay, as for now, I think the best new unit this week is Meifang. This one is the most dangerous one. The second one is Gormalas, the best pirate in the future. And Deneb will be the best astrologer because she will get astrologer plus. Soleil. Okay, another good to use 4 stars unit, magic attacker. Light element, sage. Quite good. Okay, so I think that's all for today's video. Thank you for watching, don't forget to leave a like and subscribe now if you haven't, and see you again next time. Bye bye. The Alchemist Code Global Punch.